Hi everyone, welcome back to Prakasham Tutorials. In this video, I am going to discuss about signal space analysis introduction. And this signal space analysis introduction is in digital communication system, not signals and system. And this is signal space analysis introduction in digital communication subject. And this is the block diagram of the generic communication system. So consider the basic form of digital communication system shown in figure. So this basic form of digital communication system consists of message source, transmitter, channel, receiver. And MI is the output of the message source. That output of the message source is applied to the transmitter. And SI of T is the output of the transmitter. X of T is the output of the channel. And M cap is the estimate of the message signal. So a message source, capital M symbols, a message source emits capital M symbols, each with a duration of capital T seconds. So that message signals are denoted as M1, M2, M3 and so on, MM. Assume that all the symbols are equally likely. So then the probability of the symbol produced by the source is represented as or expressed as Pi is equal to P of Mi, which is equal to 1 by capital M, for I is equal to 1 to M. The transmitter takes the message source output, MI, and codes it into distinct symbols SI of T. And this is suitable for the transmission over the channel. The signal SI of T occupies the full duration capital T, and each symbol duration is capital T. So the signal SI of T occupies the full duration capital T allotted to symbol M suffix I. Here SI of T is the real valued energy signal, or a signal with finite energy. And it is given by mathematically the real valued energy signal or signal with finite energy is defined as mathematically E suffix I is equal integral 0 to T SI square of T dt, for I is equal 1 to capital M. So now here in the block diagram, the channel is assumed to have two characteristics. There are two characteristics of the channel. And that are, first one is, the channel is linear. It has sufficient bandwidth to transmit the signal SI of T without distortion. That is the first characteristics of the channel. And the second characteristic is, the noise added to the channel is white noise. So that is, additive white Gaussian noise is added to the channel. From the equivalent model of the AWGN channel, AWGN means additive white Gaussian noise channel, the received signal X of T is given by or represented as X of T is equal to SI of T plus W of T, and SI of T is the transmitted signal, and W of T is the noisy signal, and the output of the channel or input to the filter. So the received signal X of T is SI of T plus W of T. For small t is equal to 0 to capital T and I is equal to 1 to capital M. Now the receiver has task of observing the received signal X of T for a duration of capital T seconds and making a best estimate of transmitted signal SI of T. Once again, now the receiver has the task of observing the received signal X of T. This is the received signal X of T for a duration of capital T seconds and making a best estimate of the transmitted signal SI of T equivalent. And estimate of transmitted signal means that is recovered signal, reconstructed signal. In the presence of noise, the receiver can make some occasional errors. The requirement is to design the receiver in order to minimize the average probability of the symbol error. And it is given by the average probability of the symbol error is given by or defined as P suffix E is equal sigma I is equal to 1 to M Pi into P of M cap not equal to Mi. So M cap is the estimate of transmitted signal and Mi is the message signal. M symbols. The resulting receiver is said to be optimum in the minimum probability of error. So for the first, we use geometric representation of known set of transmitted signal. The resulting receiver is said to be optimum in the minimum probability of error. For the first, we use geometric representation of known set of transmitted signal. So the geometric representation of known set of transmitted signal is Si of t for I is equal to 1 to M. And this is the introduction to signal space analysis.